Yeah. Well, good morning, guys. We're out on Lake Winnipesaukee, Meredith Bay, here with Ryan again, because he's got the day off and I'm sick today. So we're gonna go find some humps and jig on them for whatever we can find. I do want to get on a white perch bite today, but probably not gonna happen because I can't find the stupid buggers. So we're gonna gun it and let's go.
Humps like right here.
Yeah.
You think they're in here or no?
We'll find out pretty dang quick.
Where are we?
So weird.
Ooh, he was all over it.
Really?
See ya.
Did he come up to it suspended, or was it?
Yeah, I was dead sticking it, and he came up, skyrocketed to it. Oh, there he is again.
Oh God.
Oh, and he broke off.
Oh.
A little pecker head. Come here.
That looks like a good one.
Yeah, it was a good one.
The hell? Yeah, I knew it. That's smally. Maybe it's a rocky. I think it's smally though.
Well, your rod's about to snap in half, so it's probably a smally.
Dude, I was gonna say, did I?
Lake Trout?
I don't know.
It's a lake trout.
No way! Oh, no, it's not. It's a giant.
The giant smallmouth. I thought for sure, 100% sure that was a lake trout.
Dude,
that is a giant smally. Like, he's wrapped here. Let him. There we go.
I'll take that. Dude, I was like, I lifted up and I didn't feel any weight whatsoever, and I was like, okay.
There we go, there's a smallie.
I'll take that all day.
I knew you.
Two and a half, maybe? Yeah.
I don't think he's three. Oh, yeah.
Two something.
Come on, give it to me.
High twos.
Oh, 249.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, two and a half.
Two and a half. Yeah.
Just like I said. Yeah, we gotta find stuff, that, an area that looks like that.
Seriously?
Oh, just got slammed. No, at the bottom.
Oh, okay.
Definitely a lake trout. there's more down there.
I didn't even know you dropped down yet.
No, he's all at the bottom, and I didn't even set the hook. So this is. Well, hope we're gonna keep this one on, guys.
I mean, you give it to him.
I don't horse them up like you do.
Yeah.
You're not gentle with them at all.
How big is he gonna be? Oh,
he's
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, he is.
Bigger than I was catching in Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
All right, nice little lake trout, guys. Put him on the bump board real quick. Oh, he's bigger than Pittsburgh. He's 19. 19 incher, and just film the release here. This chair now makes a lot of noise. So my other chair broke, the back rotted out. And
oh,
then
really?
I took this one and I put that on the short base. And apparently this one's height adjustable. Oh yeah, I see him. I see him. Big one? Oh, yeah, it looks big. Looks big. Oh, that's decent. It's burping. That's fat. That's a fat fish.
Holy crap. There you go, guys. Nice little lake trout. Fat.
Super fat.
I hope you fish, though.
20 and a half?
20, yeah.
Ooh, I have one coming up to me. Oh, I just dropped a. Is he good?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay. It's fine.
Oh, that's that GoPro. I was like, why did this
go? No, that one's fine. So guys, we're, I know I'm probably really backlit, but we were seeing fish bust. Ooh, I just had a, I just missed a fish, dude. Come on, I was just talking to you guys and I just missed a fish in 57 feet. Ooh, there he is again. He just dropped down. I just spot locked this.
Oh,
oh, they're still there. They're still, go.
There.
There's no way that's smallies. Dude, you slam a salmon right now.
Oh, yes! Dude!
Is that a lake trout?
No, it's off!
I got one.
No way!
Cast back out there.
Dude, what? Can you tell what that was?
No, I couldn't tell. I think it was a lake trout or a salmon, dude. I'm pretty sure it was a salmon.
Or salmon too. I think it was a salmon. Oh, that was so sick. It was definitely not a bass.
No, no, way. No, it, no, and looks, I don't think lake trout jump.
It looks like some type of trout.
All right, not a lake trout, guys. Not a big one, but going right back in.
See you, bud.
Oh, there's another one right there.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Where? Oh. I can get, all right.
I don't know if I can reach that.
With my old reel, I'd have no problem. Yes.
To come on top of you. Oh, look at their boiling over there, dude. Am I on top of you? No. Where was that one?
He was close. He was closer.
Oh, I see it. We just went over a big bait ball, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
He's on.
Oh my god. Oh my god. He's a smallmouth. No way. Dude.
Smallies chasing smelt, guys, in 56 foot of water.
Oh,
all right.
Oh my god.
Well, I'm not going to even bother with that then. Not that I don't like smallies.
Oh my god. He cracked it, dude. Still don't think the first one was smallmouth. But I don't know.
I don't know.
Dude, holy crap, you are fat.
Is he?
Oh, yeah.
With the net or no?
Nah.
You're boat flipping.
Yeah.
Over here, freaking jigging lake trout and catching smallies in the same 55 feet apart from each other, vertical wise. Back in our jigging numbers, guys, after chasing down mysterious fish we determined was a smallie. Not all of them, we don't think.
Not all. Who would have guessed the old one was better than the new one?
Well, like I said, oh, he's coming up, screaming up to it. Oh. Scream.
Dude,
ooh, he
no
slammed
way
it.
Oh my god.
And my bail was open.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, I wasn't even down. I wasn't even thinking he was coming that fast at it. Jeez, guys, that thing was crazy. Tail's probably pulled down.
Dude,
he was swimming that fast. So
oh,
that
he's
was
still coming.
He's still coming.
Yeah. That's you.
No, my leader's in my rod.
Wait, what?
He stopped at that 30 mark.
Oh, look at that. Oh, there he is.
He was. I don't know where your
no,
line
it's
is.
It's not on me.
And then we used to do barnstable, and we did barnstable. Oh!
What was that? Where was that?
I don't know. I was reeling up.
Wait, you have a lake trout.
I have big lake trout on.
Do you think it's a lake trout?
Yeah.
Are you for sure it's a lake trout?
Yeah, I can't move it though.
Okay.
I was reeling up just
I thought you were talking about the smallie that I just heard jump.
No. Jeez, guys. The smallie's busting on our left. I was reeling up just to get the scope out of my line, guys. Dude, see ya.
It's right there.
I know, I see it, yeah. Huh. All right, another pretty lake trout. Another pretty lake trout. 17 incher, but fat.
Bye.
Oh, we're right on top of it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Back it up.
We want to be just off it or on it, you think?
Yeah, let's start on it.
Yeah, we can always pop off of it.
You want me to drop it?
Yep. We got fish suspended, we got fish at the bottom, guys. Oh, that was a lake trout following me. Come on.
Yeah, I see. It's somewhere in front. Oh my God, that's not a smallmouth. Whatever that was not a smallmouth.
Yeah.
That was big.
Oh, I... Ah! I had him, guys.
There he is.
Smalley?
Yep. Salmon. It's a salmon. 25-inch salmon. All right. Little Smalley. Super fat, though.
Full of smelt. Should fillet him up and get some smelt out of him.
Cut all. Oh, look at this. Look at this. You see that?
Mm-hmm.
Please.
That's definitely a fish.
Yep. It's all over. Please don't whisper.
Is he dropping down?
Yeah. He's going down too. Oh, he doesn't have it. No, he's
on. No, he's on me. He's on you? There must have been two, because the one I just had dropped. Did you just drop?
No.
Or just really disappeared off
just
the screen?
Yeah.
All right, we're right off the side of it, so let me just stop us. Oop.
Really? Oh, oh.
Got him.
Dude, you got him? Yeah. I was going to say, I... yeah, I'm assuming that must be him. I'll switch to the crappie jig. That's number four, right?
It could be.
I think it was. Yeah, four. Yeah, five.
They freak out, man.
I know. I mean, I was like, dude,
freaking death rolling.
Giant. Oh, God.
Oh, yeah. Oh, God. Stabbed him right in the head.
That was the first time. First time ever.
All right, just keep. Yeah. Yeah, I got. All right, another lake trout. Similar cookie cutter size, nice white fins. Back down.
Bye.
And I keep it physically out of the boat, so it's like out of the carpet. There's no carpet back there.
Oh, geez,
got it,
Mark. Big mistake.
Almost falling out of the boat.
Oh my God.
All right, the GoPro just glitched, but I just was helping him spike it his crappie jig, and I dropped down just messing around. I'm like, oh, there's a fish. Didn't feel it, just I saw him chase it down, and he I set the hook.
Jeez, yeah.
This feels like exactly the same size. Oh, he just got loose there for a second. All right, lake trout going back in.
he's fine.
One. Yeah, I know.
You know what? I'm gonna go for it in plastic.
Knew it. No.
Oh, it was up top, wasn't it, too?
No.
That was way up top.
Dude, he was on the bottom.
It was on the bottom? Oh, then there was a...
Sticked on the bottom.
Oh.
I think I know. I didn't break off. He's still on it.
Yeah, see if your tail is on there.
He's still on it. Oh, my God.
Get him. There we go. Big one.
It's a jig. Holy crap.
It's a small. No, how do you catch smallies like that, dude?
Dude, there's another one down there.
Is there? On the screen?
Yeah.
Or you see him?
No, like down at 40 feet right now.
Yeah.
Nice little smallmouth. Yeah, I got bit on bottom.
Just soak me. So we just tried a theory of making noise at the bottom or at the top, basically, because every time we arrived at a spot so far, the bite's been on like right away, and now we have something at 20 feet.
Oh yeah, look at that. That's actually more of a solid mark.
Yeah, it's actually like somewhat underneath me. Bite's been like right away as soon as we get there, and then it shuts right off. So we're trying to make noise just like we do for ice fishing. And he said for trout, I never thought about lake trout when he told me this. Ooh, there's a suspended mark.
Oh yeah.
Is he chasing me down?
Come on. There's no way that's not a fish. Oh, there he is. Yeah, he's coming.
Dropped off.
Oh, I see him on me too.
Get him.
You still see him?
Yep.
I still got one down. Probably between 50 and the bottom.
Yeah, he's dropping all the way down. Oh, he's coming.
Are you going faster? Oh, yeah. No way.
He's still going. Oh, he broke the 30. They do not want to go over 30.
He showed up on mine too.
What a bugger. They are like glued 30 and below today, guys. They will not come up. I don't know if it's they can see that far.
It's so perfect.
Oh yeah, right on 30, man.
Oh God.
Freaking buggers. Oh, you know what I gotta do is I gotta clean my screen.
Okay.
It's technically my fish. I'm just staying.
Okay. Hi.
Don't sit in your seat. There we go. I'm good.
This is a laker. I don't know.
It's gotta be a laker. If you catch a smallie at the bottom of 60 feet.
All right, drags get looser. Loosening it a little bit.
Don't tell him that.
It's just weight. It's just always.
Sell the boat. Oh, that's fine. Maybe that's too much.
I mean, dude,
big one?
It that much. I mean, I don't think it's big, but I don't think it's bad either. Like, I mean, I had it locked down and he was still trying to take.
Yeah. And what you don't want is like, oh, you didn't think. No.
Imagine.
Cookie cutter. Ah, no, it's a little bigger. It's
oh
a.
Oh my God! No way! Oh my God!
Dude, hold this. Hold.
Oh my God! I've always wanted to do this.
That is impossible.
Dude, that's a giant too.
That's a trophy burbot, dude.
Oh my God! Look at the smelt!
Oh, he's throwing up smelt. Look at how pretty that fish is, guys. Look at how pretty that fish is.
No way.
That is sick.
Oh my God.
Look at this guy's face, man. That is awesome.
That's amazing.
We're in 60 feet of water. The middle of summer, it is It is July 29th?
Yeah. Yeah.
29th. July 29th. And we just caught, he just caught a burbot or a cusk in the middle of summer, which is insane. Do you want to take it home?
Nah. Nah. I feel too bad keeping one that big. That's, I mean, he's probably close to five.
Well, 28. Have you caught a trophy yet?
No.
I think trophy burbot's 28. Let me, I gotta look. Or 24.
Dude, that's the last thing.
On the freaking crappie jig. On the crappie jig, man.
Oh my god.
He probably does not want to be up this high. That's 28 inches is 6, so 6 pounds, 28 inches trophy.
26. So bad. Oh my god.
Look at the size of the gills. That is, he might be just short of 28, dude. On a crappie jig, guys.
I definitely don't think it's 28.
They're supposed to be hibernating right now.
Yeah, I know.
All right, so trophy size for New Hampshire is 28. You think he's 6 pounds? Oh,
my god.
Oh no, he's 28.
Dude, it is.
Is he?
Oh,
he's bumped. He's right on the line, guys.
Right,
I would call that 28 all day. He's bumped.
It's
no, don't, yeah, don't push him that hard. He's good. I call that 28. 28 inch trophy burbot.
Yep.
Oh, is he?
Oh, yeah, yeah. 6 point. I mean, I'm literally just gonna like call it 6.
6, all right, 6 point. 6 pound. Oh, he's trophy no matter what. He's trophy weight wise if you wanted to keep him, and he's trophy
length
size.
Yeah.
All right. Let's get there.
He might not go back down.
If he doesn't, we can keep him. You might have to burp him, actually. I don't know. So we need a way to bring them down with like a piece of wire. So they use like a coat hanger.
Yeah.
And that way when the fish, so it doesn't hook them basically.
Yeah.
So we need like a blunt hook that we can drop them down with. Or break the weight off or snap. Or really light line and we can snap the hook off. So I have heavier weights too. I have like 8 ounce ones. No, how to make your own descending device, I do not know how to
how to fizz a bourbon.
Oh yeah, I guess we could just fizz him, right?
Yeah.
Which is just popping the thing. So we can do that. Sorry, buddy. We're trying to save you. We weren't trying to catch you, trust me.
Yeah,
like at all. If we descend him, he'll be fine.
Yes. Is how to descend.
So, and I can't.
I know, there's nothing to jerry-rig on that.
All right, hold on for a minute. Let me think. I have weights, so that's not an issue. If we did. So what we want to do is stick that in his mouth, and then when he gets down there.
Pull it up.
We should be able to yank it out of his mouth.
Yeah.
I think.
I mean, theoretically, it should work.
Yeah, and I don't care if we break one of these. Yeah, I don't really care if we lose all this, but yeah. So what we want to do is just drag him down, and then when we pull up, it should flip the hook up.
It should flip. Yes.
Yeah. So we're making a descending device, guys. If you can't see this already, so you grab the rod. And then when I tell you to start dropping, it's not messed up. I mean, we're trying to save a trophy fish. The thing is, this has to weigh more than his
air bladder floating.
Yeah. All right. Good.
Yep. Good. Yeah. Good.
Bail open. Yeah. Good. All right, I'll see it on the screen, and then when we...
He's going.
Oh, you got him?
Yep. It's actually
working. Seems to be working, right?
Yeah. He's still on there.
All right, when he reaches the bottom, just...
Pop him.
Good. Pull up. A We'll let it free line for a second to see if he'll pop off.
I think he's off.
Let me reel up.
Yeah, he's definitely off.
Off the...
I don't want to break the rod.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. He just starts reeling.
Yeah. This is crazy! Yeah, he's definitely not on here.
Oh wait, no, that's probably the...
No, I would... This... I couldn't hand line this up if he was on here. I'd cut my hands open.
I don't see something floating back up. I can tell you that.
Yeah, well, he's not on there.
Hey! Well, let's see if he comes back up in a little bit. That might have worked.
All right. Let's not do that again. But good job on a trophy burbot. In 60 feet of water, guys. That was a little insane. So burbot are actually supposed to hibernate. They don't actually call it hibernation. There's some other term for it during the summer. They're like dang near impossible to catch during the summer because of that. We're in 60 feet of water. The water temp is like 73 degrees, end of July, and he just hooked on a crappie jig, a 28 inch, I know you guys just saw this, 28 inch trophy, 6.6 pound trophy burbot in the middle of Lake Winnipesaukee. We're gonna go back to lake trout fishing, but we had to make a descending device. And I'm gonna show you guys that right now. So what a descending device is, and I've never seen one before until I started watching Addicted Angling, or Addicted Fishing. They're out of the Pacific Northwest. And they went up to another big lake trout place. I forget what it's called, but basically we stuck this in the fish's mouth, dragged him to the bottom, and equalized his air bladder. And that way he can stay down there into the depths he goes. But this is a walleye rig and a couple of shot or rigs that we use to to hold eels on the bottom for stripers. So now we need to fish more often together. So I'm at a trophy salmon, you're at a trophy burbot.
Trophy burbot? Oh god.
Oh, here comes one.
Oh.
I was stuck on the side of the boat and so I missed it. I was stuck over there. Son of a...
I see him, maybe I don't. No. Maybe we won't go smallmouth fishing, honestly.
But currently we're not. We're burbot, smallmouth, and lake trout fishing.
Yeah, I guess.
And one, have we caught all three species right here?
Yep.
Jeez.
Yep. Yeah.
Well, I still want to catch a white perch, guys.
One white perch.
One white perch. Be complete. What was that?
Oh my god, it's just grabbed it again.
Get him.
Reeling slowly and it's just like
yeah.
I swear to god, it's again.
There we go.
Yeah, screw you! I got you now. This ain't a bourbon.
Find a second lake trout.
Oh my goodness!
That's why he was. That one didn't count.
That makes so.
There's a lake trout like this big. It looked like a little stocky.
That makes so much sense.
That's why you're getting nipped at. All right, guys, fantastic day. Lot of party boaters out today, so it's been a little wavy, so hopefully you guys didn't get seasick during watching this video, but trophy-sized burbot, bunch of lake trout, smallmouth bass, all in 55 to 65 feet of water. Which is absolutely insane. So thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed already, subscribe. Let's go. Ryan's gonna catch one right now. Watch.
Just hit it.
Missed him. Drop down again. You can try one more time. We're off spot lock, so.